that I have to candidly many have never heard of getting this kind of attention and scrutiny. What do you think is going on here?
This is what happens when you work to change things. And first they think you're crazy, then they fight you, and then all of a sudden you change the world.
The latest now on that would-be billionaire now facing bankruptcy and possibly years in jail. Theranos founder Elizabeth Holmes appeared in court to set a trial date as she faces charges of fraud. ABC's Lindsay Davis here with that story. Good morning, Lindsay.
Good morning, George. Just a few years ago, she was named one of Forbes' richest women in America. Today, she is estimated to be worth $0, charged with an elaborate years-long fraud, accused of duping investors out of millions of dollars by claiming to have a blood testing technology that prosecutors say her company simply did not have.
First of the last 11 years, we've made it possible to run comprehensive laboratory tests from a few drops of blood that could be taken from a finger. And we've made it possible to eliminate the tubes and tubes of blood that traditionally have to be drawn from an arm and replaced it with the nanotainer.
The company Theranos hurriedly started as if it were an unstable Jenga tower. Pieces along the way kept on getting taken out, chipped out along the way, this and that from investors asking questions, lab results weren't working. Theranos was actually falsifying that their products were working, but doing lab results and tests from normal machines like Simmons. And of course, like any Jenga tower, if you start picking at the right places, it will fall, like anything else will, and as well as a company.
Can't touch this.
The FDA clearance.
And his grandfather had sided with Elizabeth Holmes and didn't believe him.
He said, "They're trying to convince me that you're stupid, but they can't do that. They can, however, convince me that you're wrong. And in this case, I do believe you're wrong." And my grandfather said that the Theranos devices were currently being used in medevac helicopters.
Did he tell you who had told him that?
He didn't say who told him that, but I have a really good guess. He also said they were being used in operating rooms. I remember saying that that couldn't possibly be true because the devices were barely working within the walls of Theranos.
Realizing his grandfather's allegiance to Elizabeth was strong, Tyler put his trust in John Carreyrou and the Journal. But it wasn't long before Elizabeth and Theranos became aware of Tyler's secret conversations with Carreyrou.
My dad said, "They know you're totally."
So I ended up talking to a lawyer and they said, you know, they're trying to scare you. And he said, one of the options that you can do is you can whistleblow. You could be protected if you talk to a regulatory agency. And I'm like, what regulatory agency? Like, how do you do that?
I've been nervous to send or even write this letter. Theranos takes confidentiality and secrecy to an extreme level. That mistakes always happen in a clinical lab. But what went on in Theranos was complete negligence and honestly felt criminal in many ways. Upper-level management constantly made excuses for their misgivings.
But they continue to still process patient samples using their fingerstick technology.
I don't feel like it's sort of a cold-blooded scam, right? It just seems it started off as something small, like one lie, and snowballed into this really crazy situation.
You can't always get what you want. confident, and from time to time, some of them work out and we get penicillin or the incandescent light bulb we get. And if you're surrounded by companies who try very hard and dedicate their lives to achieve the impossible, and then sometimes they're successful in doing it, why can't you?
At the highest level, we didn't have the right leadership in the laboratory, and I didn't realize until the inspection that these types of issues were in place.
So until the government told you that you were really out of compliance, you didn't know.
Yeah.
What was your reaction when you found out that you had all these violations in your lab?
It was devastating.
Don't blame anyone else. You have controlling shares in that company, Elizabeth Holmes. The buck stops there. People make mistakes, but you must always admit it. My husband's favorite phrase, excuses are like assholes, everyone has one. Sorry, you don't have to put that in there.